So let me know if you're hopping on, because I'd like to share my story and how I went from being depressed after surviving a brain tumor, like I had a really, really hard time, to building a successful online coaching business that basically gives me the freedom that I want, and how you can do this too, of course, because that's really important. Let me know if you're hopping on. I see that there are people hopping on. Give me a hashtag live in the comments if you're joining live. And if you're watching the replay, give me a hashtag replay in the comments. Then I know who's on here with me and who's watching the replay. So let's get into it. I'm going to share my entire story. Like, I started an online business in 2017, but that was like a lot of research. In 2018, had my very first launch, and I continued until then and found more and more success, but I would do a lot of things different than how I did them in the beginning stages. So I'm going over all of that right now in this live stream. I'm going to take you through my journey and the lessons that I've learned along the way, what I did well, what I could have done better, and what I would recommend for you guys with all the knowledge that I have now. So if you're hopping on, let me know that you're here. I love seeing you guys. So when I was 16 years old, I got diagnosed with a brain tumor. And I think having survived such an impactful, intense, horrible thing made me to the person that I am today. And it also made me this ambitious. So it's not that I look back to this time like full of negative feelings. Like, I think it has also been positive for me. But it did take a huge part of my life. It took me 7 years to recover and feel okay again, because I needed to learn many things all over again. Normal things that are normal to you, like reading, like talking, writing, things like that. Things that are super normal to you were not normal to me anymore. So let me know if you're hopping on. I see that there's a bunch of people hopping on. Give me a hashtag live in the comments, or a hashtag replay if you're watching this on the replay. So yeah, it took me 7 years to recover, and I could not even make a sandwich after my brain tumor and brain surgery, because I had brain surgery. Like, it was a really, really difficult, intense, long surgery. So yeah, that was a really, really hard time, and I struggled a lot. But while going through this, I had a lot of realizations, but the most important ones for me is that life is about the people that you love. So I want to spend as much time with the people I love as possible. Experiences are everything. Like, I'm not that much into materialism. I like experiences over everything. Like, I want to experience as much as possible. And life can be over at any minute, at any moment. So yeah, going through this made me realize, okay, you never know what happens. You never know if your health will be okay in a few months from now. You don't even know if you will be there in a few months from now. So you have to own the moment. You have to live now. You cannot postpone your dreams. So let me know if you're hopping on. Or if you have any questions when I go over my online business journey, strategies, things like that. So what I knew while I was recovering, after recovering, is that I wanted freedom. I wanted to help people, but I didn't know how exactly. Like, I had this urge. I knew that I was different. I knew that I wanted to become an entrepreneur. But how exactly? I had absolutely no idea. So entrepreneurship definitely was attractive to me, but I had no family members or friends that were in business. It was completely new to me. So I started doing research. I started reading books. I started watching YouTube videos, things like that. And during this time, Instagram was like really hot, booming. So while I was scrolling on Instagram, I saw that there were a lot of people making money on Instagram. And I had no idea how exactly, but I knew that they were doing this Instagram thing full time. And I was really impressed. Like, you're basically active on Instagram for your job, your full-time income. How can that be? So I started doing a lot of research. And my goal basically was to figure it out. And in this process of trying to figure it out, I basically developed a love for online marketing, and I quickly grew my following on social media. But I was like super, super alone at this. Like, I had no idea how to turn this into a real business, like how to monetize it, enough so that it would be my full-time thing. And then at this moment, I joined a few entrepreneur Facebook groups. Maybe like in these marketplace groups or something like that, or for my studies. But I've never been in Facebook groups before that. But I was searching for like entrepreneur Facebook groups, online business Facebook groups. And I joined them, and that's how things started to change for me. So basically, in one of these groups, I got into contact with someone from the States, and he invited me to an event in the States. And I can be really impulsive. Like, most of the time I'm not, but then I have these moments that I'm like crazy impulsive and I do like the most crazy things. So what I did is I bought a ticket and I flew over to this event, and I took a huge risk basically. And I'm happy that I took this risk. By the way, if you're watching the live stream, let me know in a comment, say hi, or give me a hashtag live or hashtag replay if you're watching this in the replay. So I flew over to this event in the States, and I learned a lot. So I basically got introduced to the knowledge industry, selling your knowledge online. Hi, Luco, good to have you here. helping people with your knowledge. So having knowledge about a certain thing and then selling your knowledge to help other people as a business model. Making money online by helping others. And then you use social media to sell these knowledge products, knowledge services. So that was like really, really amazing to me that this is even possible. And I felt like that this was my thing. This was my calling. So basically after this event, someone helped me back then. Like, I probably would have never launched if it was just me, because it made me anxious, nervous, insecure. I was overthinking everything, like every single thing, but I did launch. Like, someone pushed me to, and I did launch. And I sold my very first course, or actually I did not have a course yet. So what I basically did is I pre-sold my course. So I sold tickets for my course. I had an outline of what I was going to teach within this course, but I had not created the course yet. So I sold tickets with organic social media posts, and organic means just post on social media, on your personal Facebook account, on your Instagram account, on your LinkedIn account, without having to pay for ads or anything, just organic posting. So I did that, and I got 31 clients in that paid me for my course that I had not developed yet. And over the weeks after that, after the launch, I basically taught everything live on Zoom calls, like I'm doing right now in this live stream. But then I had all these people on. And then what I did is I recorded everything and I put that into a course portal, and that was my course. So I made money first by pre-selling my course Then, when I taught everything live on Zoom calls, I recorded it, put it in a membership portal, and after that I was able to sell my course. And I had already created it while getting paid before creating it. So I made $3,007 in one day. After that, I stopped promoting because I was just so shocked. Hi, Melissa. Good to see you on here. So let me know if you guys have any questions. So I made $3,007 in a day. I sold 31 tickets for $97 each with social media posts and Messenger. So it was mostly Facebook posts. Then in Messenger, I sent over a payment link. So payment link can be from PayPal, or what I personally use is I use Stripe and PayFunnels. So that's basically super simple. No website, no course, no nothing. So that's what I did. I taught them live on Zoom calls with my clients. So after I sold all of these tickets, I started creating my slides. Thank you, Melissa. If you have any questions about this process, let me know in the comments and I will answer them live or after the live stream if I see them too late to answer them live. I sold the tickets. I then created my slides. So after I had all these people in. So imagine, like, it could have been that nobody bought my course, the tickets for my future course. If that was true, I wouldn't have created all the slides. I wouldn't have created my program, which can take up to months, or for some people even years. Hi, Jason. Good to have you on here. Thank you. Let me know if you guys have any questions. So I already knew that it was going to sell, that it was selling, because I was already making money before I created the course. And that prevented me from working on this course for months and not being able to sell it, because that's what happens to a lot of people that get started in online business or get started in the knowledge industry, is that it takes months for them to develop a program to then notice that it does not sell, that there's no market for this course, that there's a mismatch in their messaging, in the things that they are trying to sell, that it's not something that their ideal client really desires enough to want to spend money on it. So yeah, I was already sure on all of these things because I pre-sold it and then created it. So Jason asks, how long did you teach your audience before your offer? I think it was like 2 weeks, but I already had a small audience back then. It was pretty small, but like 2 weeks, I warmed my audience up for this launch. And I did not do that in a perfect way. Like, looking back, it was awful. But it worked. Let me see, where was I? So then I continued selling this same course for a while in all different forms. So I basically sold it in the same way as I did with this pre-sell. But then I had the course already. I had different price points. I tested everything. I tested it with group coaching. I tested lower ticket products that were only a part of the full course. I tried selling it in webinars. Oh, that's another fun story. Let me see what time it is, because I have a call with my clients. What time is it? I cannot see the time. Oh, wait. Okay, plenty of time left. Yeah, that's another fun story, because I tried making a webinar to work and I locked myself up in an all-inclusive resort in Turkey. And I was like, okay, if I'm going to make a webinar work, it will be right now. Like, my full attention is going towards this webinar. I'm going to make it work. But no, it did not work. But I had a good time in this hotel. So I tried complex funnels, an entire value ladder. Like if you're pretty new to online business, this might sound a little much crazy. Like, what is that? Not going into that for now. Can do that another time if you guys want to know more about it. But sales pages. I had multiple sales pages. I had upsells and downsells. So that's where you sell one thing, and then after people purchase, they see another thing. Or when they purchase that second, do not purchase that second thing, they see another offer. So I had all of that. I tried running ads, but it was a really, really complex process. I hope it answered your question, Jason. If you have any other questions or would like a more in-depth answer, let me know. Yeah, so I tried everything that there is for coaching and courses. But I never got the same results as that one day, like during my first launch. And I was always building, always creating, and always testing. And like, I love complexity, I love building. So this process was like really satisfying to me. I really loved it. But what then happened is that I got into a really bad burnout. And I mean a big one, like I couldn't do anything but sleep, and I had to cry 24/7. So I went from doing what I absolutely love, because I did enjoy this process. Like it was really, really fun for me, to hating it. Like I could not even open my laptop. It was that bad. And I never expected that to happen. I thought I can go on for ages like this because I love it so much. So yeah, then I took a break for a few months. I stopped doing all of what I was doing before, like all these things at once. I just had to. I had to stop. But I was really confused. I was like, okay, how can I feel this way? Well, I absolutely love what I do. And how can I solve this for myself? Because I was a full-time business owner for a while already back then. And I did not want to go back. Like, I studied psychology before. I had like internships. And I knew that was like really hard work, really long days. Like, I struggle with fatigue a lot since my brain tumor. So when I would have like a 9-to-5 job, I would be tired the rest of the time. So I did not want to go back. Like, I wanted to stay an online business owner. Like, this is my thing. I want to continue doing this, but how? Because it gives me a burnout and I cannot handle like all these complex things that are giving me no or minimal results. So then I basically realized that I had to simplify everything. Because that first day, when I made these $3,007, my process was super simple, looking back. It was basically this. I had social media posts explaining what I had to offer, and they grabbed attention. I made sure that I grabbed the attention of my ideal clients right away. Then I sold the tickets by having one-on-one conversations in the comment section below my posts and in Messenger with the payment link that I just told you guys. And then I delivered my program teaching on live Zoom calls like I'm doing now. Okay, I see a comment from Melissa. I want to build a cake course. How did you start it and becoming... Can you rephrase that, Melissa? Because I think something went wrong there. I don't see a complete question. Yeah, so my process was super, super simple when I just started out. And I need to simplify again. I need to simplify to get these good results, amazing results. Yeah, so during this first launch, I made more than I did since, like $3,007 in a day. Like these years after, I didn't make that much in a day. And that was the moment that I decided to delete. So instead of adding things, adding offers, adding complex strategies, adding a webinar, adding funnels, adding upsells, adding downsells, things like that, I decided to delete them all. I deleted my funnels, I deleted everything, my webinar software, and I decided to simplify. I stopped my ads because they were still running. Removed all my low-cost offers, so I had offers ranging from $7, $47, $97, $497, $997 as well. I stopped them all. And in a few weeks from that moment, I had my biggest day in business, way bigger than the $3,007 I had before. So basically, I collected $7,900 in a day, and I contracted within this same day an additional $15,800. And I could not believe it. Like the shock that I felt in 2018 when I had that first launch was nothing compared to this day. I just could not believe it. And basically, that was not from making this money. It was from believing all this time that you need funnels, that you need a webinar, that you need to run ads, that you need to have upsells and downsells, that you need to have multiple offers, that you need to have a value letter. Like, this was so much printed into my mind that I could not believe that with a super, super simple strategy, I would be way more successful than with all of these things combined. So I could not believe it. I wish I knew this sooner. So let me know if you're hopping on and if you have any questions. Happy to answer them for you guys. Just trying to help, of course. And sharing everything that I've learned along the way, because it's been quite an intense process. Like, it's not nothing. You have to be really motivated to make all of this work. Like, it's not for everyone. Definitely not for everyone. So when I had these results, my clients were famous entrepreneurs. They were coaches. So that's how I got more into helping coaches and course creators. And I helped them with their social media to sell their offers. And we got amazing results within 1 week. I think it was like, it's in euros, but I think we sold for 70,000 euro in 1 week. So they already had an audience, but they were running ads and they were not doing that much with organic strategies. So I helped them implement that. And yeah, we got really, really fast results. So that was another thing that really impressed me, made me really happy. So I knew I was on the right track. Like, simplicity is everything. So I decided to simplify even more. So what I now do is, instead of working with everyone that asks me for help, because I get so many requests for help for all different kinds of things, social media related, but I now only focus on one type of client. And I do not work with people that do not fit this avatar, because I don't want to. So I help coaches and course creators that need more clients, or people that want to start an online coaching or course business. They want to build like a business around their passion. They have a skill or a passion and they want to build a coaching or course business around that. And it doesn't matter like if they have already started or if they're starting from zero, because they basically follow the same path from A to B. So A is wanting to start a coaching or course business, but not having one yet. And B is having paid clients. So I help them all through these exact same steps. Like, the people that have started their business already, they are a little bit further along the line from A to B, but there's probably missing something more to A that prevents them from having more success, from getting paid clients. So I take on only one type of client. And A is their starting point. B is having a successful online coaching or course business. with lots of paying clients. Yeah, so they basically all need the same social media strategies. They all follow the same path and they want the same results. Yeah, so what I basically do is, and I will get into why I do this, I help them from A to B. So A is their starting point, B is their desired result. And I help them with a life-changing result. It's not just a small win. It's a life-changing result. It has a huge impact in their life. So you cannot compare what I do to, for example, an ebook or a low-cost offer. Because with such a product, you cannot give people a life-changing result. It's just not possible for many, many reasons. You do not have the space for a lot of personal attention. You cannot have a successful business selling ebooks and giving a bunch of personal attention. That's just not, it's not going to happen. You want to give a lot of support and personal attention, and that is possible when you have what I call a transformation offer. And because I help them from A to B, and I get really great results for my clients, I am able to charge a more premium price. And my clients usually make their investment back within these 3 months. And that could imply that this is only possible for like a make money online offer. But that's not true, because most of my clients are not business coaches or not focused on making money. Only a few of them, like everyone else, is in other niches, like all different kinds of niches. So I recommend a transformation offer for you as well. If you have a skill, if you have a passion, if you have an expertise that you want to monetize. So go for one type of client as well. So not everyone that wants your services that needs help, you only help one specific type of client. You only sell one product. You only give one life-changing result. So every client that you take in, that you take on, that you help, follows the same exact path. And when you do this, instead of selling all these different things and taking on all these different types of clients, you can add a course to make it more passive, because it's from A to B. They follow the same steps. You can implement a course that guides them from A to B. You can hire coaches to make it more passive and add expertise, like I did. So I have a coach that's working for me. Laura is her name. And she is specialized in one specific area, one specific step along the path from A to B. And when you do this, when you have one transformation offer, constantly the same type of clients, you help them with the same things, the same route from A to B, you specialize. You get more expertise than others that do other things as well. You focus fully and completely on this one transformation. So you get better results for your clients because you get so specialized in what you do. You can scale your business better because you can implement all these things to make it more passive. And when you promote your services, and you guys might have noticed that, when you promote your services on social media, it's really hard to promote several services, several products, because it's already hard to communicate about one service, about one product. So when you have multiple products, and maybe even when you want to speak to multiple ideal clients, it becomes so hard, so messy. And with this one transformation offer, you speak to one person directly, you help them with the one problem, you help them get to one towards one desired end result, your communication in your social media content, in your marketing materials becomes way easier. Hi, Laura. Good to see you on here. So let me know if you guys have any questions. I see that there's a bunch of people on. So basically I wanted to share my key takeaways from this process with you guys so that I can help you speed up your process, because that's my ultimate goal. First thing is make it simple. Help one ideal client get a life-changing result. So not multiple offers, no value letter, just one type of client that wants one specific result and needs to follow a certain path towards that result. And that's where you help them with. That's where you guide them through. Stick to one offer only. You do not need more at this stage. Eventually, you can have more offers, yes. The second one, in my opinion, should be the one after your clients have followed this path from A to B and they want more. Then you still only communicate on the front end on your social media about this one offer. But when your clients complete this program, there's another offer. But you only need this first one for now. Charge high tickets. So no low cost products. That's what I've learned. Like, I tested them all. Especially as a beginner, do not start with low-cost products. It's going to be so hard. You're going to have to reach so many people for it to be profitable enough to do this full-time. So go high ticket. Make sure you have an offer that changes lives. So you want to make a huge impact. You want to offer a lot of support to your clients and make sure that they get really good results. And when you have a more higher end offer, a transformation offer, as I like to call it, you start at around charging at around $2,000 for your program. I always recommend like a 3 or 4 month program. If that makes you like really insecure, you can start at like $1,500, but I would not go any lower than this, because you, in the beginning stages, you want to invest a lot of time to get your clients to their desired result. That is really important. You want your clients to get the desired result, achieve the desired result. Then for your leads, do not run ads, do not run webinars, do not do any complex things. Just go for organic social media strategies. See where your ideal client, avatar hangs out online, and then get their attention with social media posts. It's basically as simple as that, getting attention. Then, after you get attention, you get into conversation with your ideal client. And they will tell you exactly what they struggle with and what their goals are, what they desire to accomplish. So they basically tell you what they want, and that's what you will offer them. Because, like these people, what I discussed before with you guys is, when you create a course before you sell it, you don't even know if people want this thing. Maybe their goals, their desires look way different than what you think they need. So that's what happens a lot, that there's a mismatch. You want people to tell you what they need, what they want. Basically what they want, and you give them what they need. I hope you understand what I mean. You want them to tell you what they want. Then you get them on a call, you present your offer, and you close the sale. No sales pages, no nothing. The only thing you need, let me know if you're hopping on or if you have a question. The only thing you need, social media. I prefer Facebook personal profile, as you guys know. Social media, organic, no ads. Messenger, so having conversations with people. Zoom, a Zoom account, to have calls with potential clients to see if there's a fit. Like you are the business owner. You need to decide, okay, is this my ideal client? Can I help this person? Do I even want to work with this person? So that's where Zoom comes in. So there's nothing else you need besides that. Yeah, the payment link that has been discussed before, but nothing else. And stay focused. So that's, I think that's also really important. You want to stay focused. That's something that I struggled with a lot as well. Because when you are active on social media, when you read books, when you just try to get more knowledge in this online business world, there's a lot of shiny objects that are preventing you from having focus. And I fell for that as well. But I would recommend like going for one strategy. And if that's this one, like this simple strategy that I just explained to you guys, or if you do want to go for like a really complex thing, I would not recommend it, but of course it's your business. You have to decide for yourself. If you choose one strategy, go for it. Do not hop from one strategy to the other, because that's not going to work. Stay focused, stick with one strategy. And my last takeaway is no need for complexity. You can build a highly profitable coaching or course business around your passion without webinars, funnels, and other complex strategies. So I see that there's still a lot of people on. Do you guys have any questions? Then I can still answer them during the live stream. Otherwise, if you have questions, just drop them in the comments and I will answer them after the live stream. Because I'd love to hear from you guys. No questions? Then I think that's it for now. By the way, if you are not yet in my group, you can go to socialmedialifestyle.com and then my group will automatically pop up. So definitely join my group, because I will do live streams like this more often in my group. And yeah, let me know if you guys have any questions, need help, in a comment, and I will reach out to you. Have a great day and great weekend. Bye-bye.